He has had a couple really good games. They need both him and Antti Raanta to step it up and improve their saves moving forward.
He's the captain of his youth hockey club. He's on the bench for the first period tonight with the Flyers as the honorary team captain. And we'll show you even more of the experience that the Flyers have put on high-quality scoring opportunities for either team in the first five as Farabee gave it away. And moving it is Aho. Puts on the brakes. That's the best shot we've seen so far. A wrister off the right pad of Carter Hart. Good job by Dmitry Orlov to pick the pocket of Farabee, who looked like he might jump right across the Carolina line. Aho with a drop. Long wrister from Jalen Chatfield was on net. Aho puts it in the blue paint. Save, the rebound, score! Michael Bunting breaks the ice here in Philadelphia. He's promoted up to the top line with Sebastian Aho, and just like that, he's got his fifth of the season.
Yep, they had one rush, came back, and as you mentioned, a play was broken up, and then watch this pass just over to Jalen Chatfield, a quick long-range shot. Chatfield's a little more defensive, but what the Canes do well is they jump on all the rebounds, and they're able to corral the puck. They get it from outside, and they're able to put it inside, and Bunting's there in a perfect spot. You know, if you watch the way Aho passes that, it's off the heel of his stick.
It's amazing. They are 11-1-0 when they score the first goal, and 0-8-1 when the opposition scores first.
That was a you mentioned Lemieux in the lineup, haven't played for a couple weeks, but he's there. A couple good opportunity offensively.
A little over 8 minutes gone by in the opening period as Tyson Forster gains the zone. A little 360 wheel around backhander. Kachetkov sticks that one aside. Bobby Brink gets it free on the edge of the blue paint. And now it is sailed out to the neutral zone by Marty Natchez. Right back across the Carolina line. Chatfield and Poehling come together. Chatfield backhands it around. Poehling a near takeaway. Now he has the puck off to Farabee. Plays it to himself in the corner and takes a big shoulder from Chatfield. I'm right back to his D partner. Midway through the first. Pesci again. Couldn't get it past Deloria. Lawton down in the right wing corner. Off the blocker of Kachetkov from a nearly impossible angle. And lifted free by Pesci. A bouncing puck off the shin guards of Sanheim. And he will chase it down. York backhands one off the near glass. Chopped center circle by Lawton. There is Sanheim stepping in. And he'll fork it deep and hop over the boards. All five Flyers change.
Good play there by Sanheim. Get down low, uses his glove to make sure that bouncing puck doesn't get by him. He knew they needed a change.
Brent Burns moves in. Shoot, save made by Hart. Hits the high glass over the top of the net of Kachetkov. Natchez gave it away. Konecny down low. Sanheim to the forehand again. And kept it out of the net was Kachetkov.
We've talked about him in the open. He's been offensive for this team. Check this out. He comes in, not only takes this chance here, and the whole team is supporting him, but he stays down low. He ends up getting the puck back, and it's great work by Konecny to give it back to him. And what a great play to try to come back. Teravainen gets that save. He sweeps it
right back to York straight away. York to the backhand around Natchez. Puts it down low between the legs, Couturier. Sanheim tried to pull one and toe drag, and that was denied.
And after that, Teravainen takes a shot, but do you think Kochetkov gets a save for Teravainen's stick there? Probably not.
Well, Kochetkov just got another save on the opportunity by Atkinson. Tip it with a wrister. That sails just wide. Where could it be more?
Right.
A better fit for any team than with a man advantage.
And maybe just that, right? Not playing top 6 minutes, but just getting out there and being a power play specialist.
Face off to the right of Carter Hart. Won by Stahl. Burns, wrist shot, chest save is made by Hart. And he's able to control the rebound. Acknowledged by the crowd, almost tried to hide behind Torts.
I know that.
As adorable as it gets, and just exactly what a young kid that's going through the unimaginable deserves.
He's got a calm demeanor about him, simmering under the surface for sure. You know the intensity is there. But when he was talking about Svechnikov, he said he was doing everything right.
Mason in as he puts a shoulder into York behind the net. Chip to Poehling on net. Blocker save made by Kachetkov.
Antti Raanta left the game early against Edmonton last week. He seems to be back and fine, but Fyodor Kochetkov looks very solid in between the pipes.
And a two-on-one shorthanded. Aho and Jarvis. Across to Aho. Shoot. Save made by Hart. Moving from right to left. On the doorstep, sweeping is Jarvis. A bank pass ahead to Nason. Into the corner stall. Sweeps it around the boards. Back to Burns. Long snapshot off the blocker of Hart. And a possible breakaway. Here comes Konechny. Score! What an outlet pass, and Konechny sneaks behind the Canes defense. That's the game at one.
Beautiful goal finished by Travis Konechny, but it starts all the way back in their defensive zone. It's a big rebound. And a great heads-up play by Forster. The rebound comes to him. He already knows that he's got Konechny busting down to the far blue line. So a quick retrieval of that rebound, which is bouncing a little bit. And Forster, you know, we talked about their power play woes. They only have 7 power play goals on the season. 2 of them came from Konechny.
A turnover. Stahl with a look and an arm save made with either the shoulder or right blocker by Carter Hart here in the second. Long wrister. From Stahl, sails just wide. Ristolainen pinches in. Behind the net, controls the puck. Wheel around Rister from a hard angle. Kachetkov was ready.
They usually allow an average of 25 a game.
And they are number one in the NHL in fewest shots allowed per game. And here's a giveaway. And a right pad save made by Carter Hart.
And he said these goalies are going to figure it out. They're going to start getting better numbers. And their 8 goals that Ronta gave up to Tampa Bay certainly didn't help his numbers.
Throwing one out in front is Nason. That's blocked in on Hart. The rebound. Score! Inserted into the lineup, Brendan Lemieux in place of the ill Andrei Svechnikov. And look who puts the puck in the back of the net. It's Lemieux. And that gives Carolina the lead back.
They jump on loose pucks and they retrieve loose pucks. And this board batter behind. This is the fourth line you're talking about. Drury, Nason, and Lemieux inserted. But they're just hard work along the wall. And there is a funny carom off a skate here right now. It's a rebound, and you can see it, the puck is trying to be cleared there by Scott Laughton. Right here, it goes off Lemieux's shin pad. Quick reaction save, and then Lemieux just beats Laughton to that loose puck. So that's just a hard-working shift. That's what this line has done really well.
A rolling puck hops off his stick right back to the neutral zone. Drury, and there's one right back in for Jarvis. Centering pass. Oh, that shot on net by Aho. Steered aside by Hart. You talk about how relentless Carolina can be. Shots on net since the Konechny goal, 13-4. In favor of the Canes. They've got the lead, and they start this period on the power play.
Fluid play, too. The way Aho plays it, you never know where he's going to go.
Right to the net. Backhand one, and Aho puts it on net. Hart able to make the save.
This is just on the zone entry, too. You watch the way the Teravainen comes in. He's got Aho with him, and it's a great play by Aho.
Brings it right back in. Carries behind the net. Look to center one. Instead does a lap. Back to the point. Long wrister. Side of the net. Wrap around try. Stop. Put the stick back to Chekhov. He denies Farabee. It's in the far corner. And it looked like he struggled with that deflecting wrister in spite of how far away it was launched from. Jarvis after it. Some open ice. Sanheim closes the distance. Score! A wrister by Jarvis snuck under the left pad of Carter Hart. It looked like he had it and almost kicked it into his own net. And it's a 2-goal lead for Carolina.
Pouring on the pressure at the other end of the ice, and you can see the Flyers are converging. They've got to take risks at this point in the season. Excuse me, this point in the game. And they go down and set Jarvis afterburners on getting that puck. He has Travis Sanheim, who we talked about how great he's been angling him. Sanheim plays that well. He's shoulder to shoulder with him, forces Gate back to kick it, instead puts it in the net.
Well, the net empty. That shot by Teravainen was blocked. Now the Flyers need a pair. And that is an empty net goal thrown in from the half wall left wing side. That will make this a 4-1 lead. And congratulations for Kotkaniemi, as that is about as easy as they come. And that will put Carter Hart back in his net.
Honestly, I beg to differ. Easy as they come, Bob, I'd like to see you do that. Where he's sitting over there on the side, he's a left shot, so his angle's a little tough. He's got pressure here. He gets his eyes up between the legs, and he threads the needle. So, granted, no goalie there, but still, that's
ESPN Plus Hulu exclusive coming up a couple of nights from now. And Ferraro and Steve Levy will have the call as the Canes will take on the Islanders, another team that right now they are in the general vicinity of. in the Eastern Conference playoff picture. But the final 4-1.